Question 31 takes us into our logarithm section, and there are three properties of logarithms. When we subtract, we're going to divide. When we add, we're going to multiply. And when we have a number of multiplication, it becomes exponents. Okay, so the three properties, let's do it down here. So if we had some log function, any base, doesn't matter. We'll leave it blank. Well, let's put a base A of x minus log base A. The bases have to be the same of y. So we're subtracting. We can write it as a single logarithm of log base A of x divided by y. So that's what we're going to put in this first one. So we are going to 3, 11, it's going to simply be 11 divided by 4. That's a one property, not necessarily, well, it's the first one for this question. 11 divided by 4. That doesn't reduce or anything, so that's good to leave that. Now, the second sort of property of logarithms, so that's the first one, second one, is if we had log base A of x plus log base A of y, we end up with the log of A of x times y. So we're looking at, we've got up here 22, and something times 2 equals 22. You could do it by sort of 22 divided by 2 is 11, right? So that's, it's got to be 11 here that goes into there, because and again, we think of 11 times 2 equals 22. And that's the property we're using here, so we fill that in with 11. And finally, the third main property, a third main, I don't know if order is not really important, but the third one is if you have some number, say x, log a of y, when we're multiplying a logarithm by a number, it can be written as an exponent. So this becomes log base a of y raised to the x power. So that's what's going on here. This number in front, we still got our logarithm. We can rewrite it as 3 to the second power. And 3 to the second power is equal to 9. And yeah, so that's you can't really do that with the calculator. You need to use the principles, the characteristics of logarithms. That's 31.